watching a video. Well, I'm listening to a it's a podcast. I'm listening to a podcast of 19 Keys and Dr. Kawa Kamin. And they're just talking about different subjects, right? But this one, like, I've been connecting with everything they're saying, but this one specifically opens a door of knowledge that I did not know I withheld into just now, like a minute ago. And Dr. Kaba said that, for one, you can't connect with no one else if you can't connect yourself. That's why a lot of our relationships fail or end up chaos, friendships, all kinds of things, because we try to attach ourselves to things that really don't balance with who we are, but we don't know who we are, so we attach ourselves to everything. Said that if in life you have not, your head have not been taken from you, as your head as in your consciousness. What is our consciousness? Your consciousness do what? It connects us to the divine. It connects us to God, to the creator. So if in life, he said, if in life your head has not been taken from you, if in life your consciousness have not been taken from you, stolen from you, you will be accepted in the gates of heaven and take your place. I've watched a few videos of, like, Christians saying that they had near-death experiences and God told them that they weren't welcome in heaven because they haven't really just had that connection with him. But he was like, well, I go to church. Oh, I'm a preacher. I'm a pastor. I go to church. I do this every Sunday, Wednesday, whatever. But I was like, yeah, but in all those things you did at church, I was not present. So that's why I said that, what he said about the head, your consciousness. People get so caught up in a religion that it's, you make it an external thing, when in reality, it's spirituality before religion. Why? For the simple reason that, like I said earlier, just now previously, you can go to church, you can do X, Y, Z, but if your spirit is not one with God's, if you do not know self, you do not know who you are, then it doesn't matter how you can sleep and wake up at church day in and day out, but if that connection is not present, you will not go to heaven. So it's not about the religion, it's all about the spirit, the spiritual aspects of our humanity, of our life, of who we are, what we are, because it starts within. It's not external. When you decide to join a religion, Christianity, Catholic, Muslim, whatever you want to, or you decide you want to be a part of, whichever religion you decide you want to be a part of, you do it with the intention of getting closer to the Most High, getting closer to God, right? And every religion is the same. We all join a religion in the purpose of getting closer to God and making our life better, changing for the better, growing spiritually and in life, right? But that can be done if we don't put the effort. It don't matter what religion it is. It cannot be done if we do not detach from the outside world and connect with self, connect with our spirit, and enter the spiritual realm. So we have to find God in the spiritual realm. God isn't an external thing. God is within. In Christianity, I can speak for that because my family and my mom, I mean, they're Christians, right? But it's about the spirit. I always told my mom, it's about the spirit. So I know it's a lot of rules in the Bible that said this can't do that, you can't do that, but it's like you putting a restriction to your authentic self because of something you read, which was not meant to be taken literal to begin with. Going to church alone and doing church things only at church, or godly things only at church, that's not going to change your life. That's not going to get you closer to God. You have to do things when no one's around, when no one's looking. together who truly find God, because you're doing it in heart and spirit and in mind, because you have to constantly think about that. I'm not going to go out today because I really want to pray. I really want to read this chapter. I really want to finish this verse. That was the end of